بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين، شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين، محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is indeed his final messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters, as you know, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم every now and then would remind people as to what is the core of his message. Why did Allah send Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? Allah tells in the Quran that he was sent as mercy to mankind. And then the Prophet, peace be upon him, would even be more specific as to what is the core, what is the essence of the teachings of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So in a beautiful, subtle fashion, the Prophet, peace be upon him, says, إِنَّمَا بُعِدْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. He said, I was sent by Allah so that I may complete, I may perfect the best of characters for mankind. People are inclined to be good. And he said, I was sent so that I may enhance the goodness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already created people with the inclination towards it. And that's why the Prophet, peace be upon him, would say it so beautifully. He said, أَكْمَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِمَانًا أَحَاسِنُهُمْ أَخْلَاقٍ. Those who are more complete in faith are those who have the best of character. Or he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, أَقْرَبُكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَ أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. The closest to you in position to me in the day of judgment will be those who have the best of manners, the best of character amongst you. And that is what, subhanAllah, in Islam, it is not enough to just believe. You must act upon your belief. And that is why they say, if what you believe in does not impact how you behave, then what you believe in is not important. If what you believe in does not impact how you behave, then what you believe in is not important. What good is it that you speak about justice, but you yourself, you are an oppressor? What good is it that you speak about honesty, but you cheat? What good is it that you speak about integrity, but you yourself do not live a life of uprightness? What good is it? So we say, if what you believe in does not impact how you behave, then what you believe in is not important. But then again, when we speak about character, that's such a broad topic. But there are certain elements that make up good character that must be present in each and every one of us. And very fast, we call them the six C's of character, where each and every one of these characters begin with the letter C. And there are six essential components of having good character. The first component of having good character is what we call conscience. Dhamir. And subhanAllah, Allah created each and every one of us with an internal moral compass that guides a person. That sometimes you look into it and say, I just don't feel good about it. Something bothers me in here. That is your conscience. Listen to it. It said that once a man by the name of Wasim ibn Ma'bad, he said, I was thinking to myself one evening and I said, tomorrow morning after the Fajr prayers, I am going to be the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm going to ask him, O Prophet of Allah, define to me what is righteousness and what is sin. He said, I woke up in the morning and I came to the masjid, but it was packed. It was full. And I here I am, I want to speak to the Messenger of Allah, but there is no place. So I said, I started walking and I started pushing people to the side. And people keep telling me, oh, Wasim, but you came in late. Sit at the back of the masjid, that's where you belong. He said, no, inni uridu Rasulullah. He said, no, people, I want to speak to the Messenger of Allah. Then he said, the Prophet look at me, and we made eye contact. And he smiled, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I said, when he smiled, that gave me green light, that I can proceed. He said, I came and I sat so close to the Prophet, peace be upon him, that my knees were touching his knees, and that my hands were on his thighs. Then the Prophet of Allah looked at me and he said, oh Wasim, if you wish, I can answer your question before you ask it. And if you wish, you can ask your question and then I will answer it. Wasim said, Prophet of Allah, please, you answer my question before I ask it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you are here to inquire about what is righteousness and what is sin. Said, this is exactly what I came here for, Prophet of Allah. Then listen to the definition that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave. He said, al-birru al-khulq. He said, righteousness is all about having good character. That is what righteousness is. Righteousness is not about the length of your beard. It's not about the length of your prayers. It's not about the length of your robe or your garment. That is all part of the deen, yes. But it does not necessarily make you a righteous person. So the Prophet of Allah said, righteousness is about having good character. And sometimes, subhanAllah, it's so sad that we amongst Muslims, either people have good ibadah, good acts of worship, but they have terrible akhlaq manners, or sometimes people have good manners, but they are spiritually bankrupt. They don't pray, they have no connection with Allah. People say, well, which one is better? Is it this person or that person? We say, neither. This is like me asking you, would you like to pluck out your left eye or your right eye? Neither. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, righteousness is about having good character. And then he defines sin, and he said, and sin is that which flicks in your heart and you don't want it to be public. وَالْإِثْمُ مَا حَاتَ فِي صَوْرِكَ وَخَشِيْتَ أَنْ يَطَّلِعَ عَلَيْهِ النَّاسِ. So it flicks in your heart. Don't feel good about it. And then he said furthermore that you wouldn't want it to be exposed to people. But here the point is the Prophet ﷺ is referring to this idea of conscience. Living with conscience. Obeying that inner moral compass that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us with. So, a person of character is a person who has a living conscience. And that is why sometimes we refer to some people and we say, what happened to your conscience? Is your conscience so dead? Why do you do that? How can you employ people but not pay them back? What happened to your conscience? Is it so dead? And subhanAllah, they say, if we do not listen to our conscience, that voice keeps fading away. To the point that we say, your conscience is dead. Sometimes the Quran refers to it as fi qulubihim marad. There is disease or sickness in their heart. Because they don't obey that conscience. So the first C is conscience. The second C is consideration. Consideration means that you are deliberate. You are thoughtful. Before you say anything, before you do anything, you think, how is this going to impact the people who are around me? A person who is of character is a person who is considerate. They care for the people around them. How you make people feel matters. One of the most beautiful examples said by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said that after the conquest of Mecca, people started fleeing away. They fled because they knew that if the Muslims are going to come, they are going to take revenge and most likely they will die. So people started running away. One of the people who ran away is Ikrimah, the son of Abu Jahl. You all know who Abu Jahl is. notorious villain, vicious opponent of Islam and Muslims. His own son is running away. His wife came to the Prophet of Allah and she accepted Islam. And then she inquires, "Oh Prophet of Allah, what about my husband, Ikrimah? What do we do?" The Prophet said, "We have granted him immunity. Khalas, amnesty is being given to him." She said, "Prophet of Allah, he will not believe." They said, "The Prophet took off his turban and he gave it to her and said, 'Show him this.' In the Arab country, if you take off your turban, that's a big deal." So she met with her husband and she said, "Close that. The Prophet of Allah has granted you amnesty." He said, "I don't believe you." She showed him the turban of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he started coming back and in all the way he's thinking about Muhammad and peace be upon him and this Messenger of Islam. And it's very appealing to him, so he decided that he's going to accept Islam. However, on the way, he sees the Prophet of Allah and he sees people sitting around him. And then the Prophet sallam to the people sitting around him makes a beautiful, remarkable statement. He said, "Hada Ikrimah, yaqul ana mu'minan fala tasubbu aba." He said, "This is Ikrimah. He is coming to declare his Islam. Do not mention his father, who is Abu Jahl, with any ill words." And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, "For mentioning those who fast away with ill words, they won't hear it, but it will only hurt the feelings of those who are alive." That is beautiful, man. That is beautiful. This is a project where it would be so justified to say anything about him, but the Messenger of Allah said, "Don't do it in front of his son. He is still his father, as bad as the man was, but he is still the father. He is still the son, so don't do that." And sometimes we are so inconsiderate. Sometimes people spoke and then they come to the masjid. "I come to the masjid because I want spiritual upliftment. I come in and I cannot concentrate on my prayers because the person who was praying next to me, they just smoked a pack before they walked into the masjid and they deprived me of any sense of the spirituality in my prayers." We do this when we don't care what our behavior does to people. See the way that people drive. Can be very inconsiderate. It's all about me, myself, and I. What I do to those who are around me does not matter. That is not acceptable. Or even worse, what the Prophet said about certain type of men. They beat their wives during the day and then they expect to sleep with them at night. That is very inconsiderate. That is very ill. The Prophet said, "لا يكون أحدهم كالفحل يضرب زوجته بالدهان ثم ينام معها بالليل." Say, one of you should not be like a beast where they beat their wives during the day and then expect to sleep with her at night. What happened to you? Why won't you be considerate? So a person of character is a person of conscience and is a person who is considerate, deliberate about what you say and how you say. And you care so much for what you say and what you do and how it makes people around you, how it makes them feel. A person of character is a person that brings joy to the people who are around them. In the hadith, the Prophet is asked, "Ya Rasulullah, ma ahabbul a'mal ila Allah, qala idkhalu as-surur ila qalbi al-mu'min." O Messenger of Allah, what is the most beloved deed to Allah? The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "To bring joy into the heart of another believer." Don't bring depression. Don't bring anxiety on the people around you. He said, "No, bring good news. Bring joy into the heart of the people who are around you." The third C is compassion. People who are kind. People who have the ability to sympathize with the unfortunate events, the difficult circumstances that happens to people around us. Because life will throw things at us. And we want to be empowered by those who are around us, feeling with us, feeling for us, helping us out. But remember this, my brothers and sisters. Being good to those who are good to us does not make us good. Being kind to those who are kind to us does not make us kind. Can we still be kind to the people that do not necessarily deserve it? Can you still be good to the people who are not necessarily good to you? Can you do that? It was said that one time Abdullah ibn Umar went to the market to buy. And when he chose the products that he wanted to buy, he put his hands in his pocket and found out that somebody has robbed him of his money. So he said, "I'm sorry, somebody's been in my pocket and they took my money." So the man, the businessman that he was dealing with, was so upset. He said, "Somebody stole the money of the companion of the Prophet, peace be upon him. May the curse of Allah be upon that person." And everybody in the market, they raised their hands and they said, "Oh, Ameen." Then Abdullah ibn Umar raised his hands. And he said, "Oh Allah, if this man stole my money because he was in need, oh Allah, bless my money for them. And oh Allah, if this person stole my money because they are a thief, oh Allah, make this the last of their sins." That is beautiful. That is beautiful. And what good would it do if you pray against the man? But the man here is saying that I can still be compassionate, even to those who may not look like they deserve it. And Abdullah ibn Umar gives that beautiful example. A person of character is a person of conscience. They are considerate. They are compassionate. And they also say that they are people of courage, shaja'ah. Because many times standing up for evil, standing up for our own principles and values, it requires commitment, but it also requires a lot of courage on our part. Especially if we live in an area around people that may not necessarily share the same values. The same principles that we have, standing up for that requires a lot of courage. And that is why the Prophet ﷺ would urge the believers. And he would say, أَلَا لَا يَمْنَعَنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ مَخَافَةُ النَّاسِ مِنْ أَنْ يَقُولَ حَقًّا إِذَا رَآهُ أَوْ سَمِعَ بِهِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُبَاعِدُ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَلَا يُقَدِّمُ مِنْ أَجَلٍ. He said, do not let your fear of people stop you from speaking against injustice when you see it or you come to learn about it. For people neither have the ability to withhold that which Allah chose to give you, and they can neither bring closer that which Allah has delayed for you. They can't do that. So the Messenger of Allah said that you must have courage. Not just in the battlefield, that does not make you courageous. He said you must have the courage in standing up for your values, for the principles that you adhere to, you commit to it. But that commitment requires that you be a person of courage. And then number five, my brothers and sisters, they say that a person of character is a person of control. Meaning that we are emotionally wise. Wisdom is not only about our thoughts, but also wisdom also is about our feelings. The ability to be in control over your desires and not the other way around. The ability that you are in charge of your own self and not necessarily that yourself is in charge over you. That requires a sense of control. Isn't Ramadan just a time for people to learn the sense of control? Isn't Salah, isn't Zakat, isn't everything an invitation that you be a person of control? And subhanAllah, what we see now is happiness is out of control. People are out of control. The speed is out of control when people drive. Even with your credit card, people are out of control. Best definition I heard of a credit card, they say a credit card is a tool that we use to buy things we don't need, at a price we cannot afford, with money we don't have, to impress people we don't even like. Why is it? Lack of control. Go ahead, want, can't even control our desires. Can't control our this and our that. So it's a person of character is a person who has an ability to always be in charge, especially of himself and herself. Must be in charge of everything. That is why Ibn Qayyim speaks about you must take the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you must pass through your own nafs. You've got to be in charge of yourself before you can make it, before you can make your way in connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And finally, a person of character is a person of confidence. Meaning that you do what is right. You may not necessarily immediately see and reap the fruits
of the goodness that you have done, but you are confident that the right thing needs to be done. Even though at this point I may really not see, but do the right thing. With full confidence that in the long run, the right thing was the right thing to be done. We can't be selective about the right thing. The right thing is something that needs to be done all the time, even if immediately it's not to our advantage. But do the right thing. And inshallah, when we implement these six pieces of character, we can say we are on the right road to having a good character. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all good character, ya Rabbi Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واستغفر الله لكم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بأثاره اقتفى. The beauty of Islam, brothers and sisters, is not only in what is spoken, that is beautiful, but Islam is more beautiful when it is put into action. The action of it is what is missing. The beauty of our deen is in the implementation of it. We can say very eloquently all the goodness about Islam, but by the end of the day, if this goodness is not implemented, then what is it? And that's why we began by saying, if what you believe in does not impact how you behave, then what you believe in is not important. See, I come from the States. And subhanAllah, over there, people are exposed to Islam. But they're exposed to the wrong Islam. And that is, they see on the newspapers, they see on their TVs, that the name Islam only comes up when something bad is taking place in the world. When the perpetrators are Muslims, and what has taken place is something that is absolutely horrific, then that's what they know about Islam. What they know about Islam is bombings and killings and bloodshed and people walking into a masjid bombing themselves up. And sometimes we say, people's wrong impression of Islam is people's right impression of the Muslims. People's wrong impression of Islam is people's right impression of the Muslims. This is not to make a general statement. But what happens is, what image of Islam are we given? We like to complain, oh, Muslims, Islam is not like that, Islam is not like that. Then what is it? Where do we find it? Where do we see it? We have to bring out that beauty of our deen. And the way that we bring it out is in this idea of how does it impact our character? What kind of people become out of me? What kind of a person comes out of me as a result of me saying that I bear witness that the best method, the best of ways is the way of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Then that's where Islam and the beauty of Islam comes in. People keep asking us, you tell us that what we see on TV is not Islam, then why don't you tell us what Islam is? Where do we find it? What are the Muslims doing to one another? Where do we find it? So we say, the beauty of our deen is in the doing, is in the implementation of it, and not just us talking about it, but it has to be something that is implemented. You know, they once asked people, they said, which animal scares you most? Which insect, which anything scares you most? 85% of the people said they hated mice and rats. Said they're very scared of mice. 85% of the people are scared of mice. They don't like them. We have a very important question to ask. How come Mickey Mouse is the most famous personality in the world? How come? If 85% of the people are so scared of it, how come it's the most famous personality? Because somebody took that image and represented it to people. We have a beautiful product. in the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so we have done a terrible job in presenting it. The presentation is not good. And that's why we say, why don't we begin with our own selves? When each one of us is an ambassador of Islam, an ambassador representing the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in our own families, in our own localities, with the employers, with the employees, so that we can say Islam is beautiful. And we can take pride in the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, look at what it has done to me and what it made out and what it made out of. Negate the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, لا إيمان لله أمانة له. A person cannot claim faith if they cannot be trusted. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no good in he who does not bring goodness to those who are around him. There is no goodness in him whom his neighbors or her neighbors cannot trust. So the idea is, the beauty of our character comes out in the way that we deal with one another. Please, let's pay attention to this. That how we deal with other people is making a statement about what kind of people we are. Again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best of characters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who are fully conscious of him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to be considerate to those who are around us. Give us the courage to stand for what is right and avoid and eliminate what is wrong. Allahumma innaka afuwwun kareemun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu 'anna. Allahumma farij hamma al-mahmumin wa nafis karab al-maqlubin wa qdi ad-dayna 'ala al-madinin. Allahumma ya rabbal mawtana واشف مرضانا وفك اسرانا وعاف مبتلانا واختم الصالحات الباقيات اجلنا. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه.